Hello everyone and welcome. In this tutorial, I would like to show you how to overcome the unable to export at this resolution, please lower the resolution and try again message in Adobe Illustrator. When you create art to upload to POD sites like Society6 and Redbubble, they give you a recommended size to start with. For instance, here on Society6, they say if you want to start with a format, you can start with 15,000 by 9,000 or 8,000 by 12,000 or 12,000 by 12,000 at 300 dpi. Although they do tell you that you need to upload different dimensions for different products, just a side note there. In Redbubble, they tell you to start with 7,632 by 6,480 pixels. So let's say you decide you have a square piece of art that you want to use and you decide to start at 12,000 by 12,000 pixels at 300 ppi. Now creating and saving this file in Adobe Photoshop is no problem, but when you try to save this file as a JPEG in Illustrator, you get the message, unable to export at this resolution, please lower the resolution and try again. Now, I don't know why Illustrator does this. I'm sure there's a very good reason. I'm also sure that my non-mathematical brain would not be able to wrap itself around the reason when somebody does explain it to me. Here's what I do know. When Illustrator tries to save that file that you created at 12,000 by 12,000 pixels, it is actually creating or trying to save a file that is approximately 50,000 by 50,000 pixels. If I did my math correctly. So how do we overcome this issue? We have to do a little bit of math ourselves. So here's what you need to do. If you would like your final piece to save at 12,000 by 12,000 pixels, you start with 12,000, divide by 300, multiply by 72. Then you're going to get a file size of 2,000 or a number of 2,880. Now, let's go test it. So I'm going to create a new file. I am going to put in those dimensions that we just got. 2,880 by 2,880. And I'm going to click Create. Now we're just going to fill it with a square. Same size as the artboard. I'm just going to fill it with pink, no stroke. Okay, now I'm going to export this file as a JPEG. So we're going to go to File, Export, Export As. I'm just going to name it Pink Square. Ooh, I can't spell today. Use Artboards and Export. I'm going to leave everything the same over here. Click OK. And then we're going to wait for it to save. Now, once it's saved, if we did our math correctly, it should save a document that is 12,000 by 12,000 pixels. Okay, now if you reverse this math, so let's go back to the calculator while this is saving. If you reverse the math and you say 2,880 divided by 72 multiplied by 300, you get 12,000. So let's do that math with the very large, starting with the 12,000. So we initially set up a file of 12,000 and that's where we got the message. So let's see what size file Illustrator was actually saving. So 12,000 divided by 72 multiplied by 300, 50,000. So it was trying to save a file that is 50,000 by 50,000 pixels. All right, so that's obviously why it couldn't save. So let's go and open up the folder where we saved it. I just actually saved it on the desktop. There's our pink square. Now, if I right click, go to properties, click on details, and I scroll down. Dimensions, 12,000 by 12,000 pixels, width, 12,000 pixels, height, 12,000 pixels, 300 dpi. And that's perfect. That's exactly what we want. So I know it can be incredibly tedious to have to do the math for every file that you want to create, because like I said before, you can't create just one file for all your products. They're going to look a little bit funny. So let me show you what I did. I created a Google Doc or a Google Sheet that actually does the math for me. So I just insert the math. So let's say I want to create an artboard that is 10,000 by 8,000 pixels. I type in 10,000. And then if you look over here, it's already worked it out for me. It's 2,400 by 8,000. And then we look over here, by 1920. And that does the math for me very quick. I don't have to take out a calculator. Google Sheets just does the math for me because I just inserted it in there. So why don't you do the same? Go create a little spreadsheet for yourself and you can do the math yourself. If you just want to use mine, you're welcome to. Just sign up below and I will send you the link. Then you can just click save a copy and you can calculate your file sizes quick. Okay, I hope this tutorial was helpful and that it makes sense. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions or anything that I need to make clearer. And I'll be back soon with another tutorial. Enjoy creating, everyone. Bye.